I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis sitting with us all over the world at this moment through Nityananda TV, Sadhana TV, Ishwar TV, Janashri TV and through two-way video conferencing having Nainadiksha in many cities in many countries around the world. Cities sitting with us, Toronto, Kailasam, San Jose, Madurai, Nityananda Nagara, Bangalore, Huzur, Dhyanapeetam, Houston, Kalahasti, Winnipeg, Canada, Ohio, Prayag, Los Angeles, Arunachalam, Vancouver, Bhuvaneshwar, Monterey, Kedarnath, Adi Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Avattipalayam, Hyderabad, Guptakashi, Johor Bahru, Tiruchandur, Tiruvanmiyur, Dhyanapeetam, Chennai, Oklahoma, Somanatham, Indrani, New Jersey, Enriching Temple, Bididi, Madurai, Dhyanapeetam, Coimbatore, Dhyanapeetam, Phillip Islands, Australia, Oman, Sivagangai, Kanchipuram, Nityananda, Dhyanapeetam, Kulim, Tiruthani, Jorpati, Nepal, Tallahassee, Florida, Seattle, Chidambaram. I welcome all of you. Some more cities have joined. Kuala Lumpur, Palani, London, Kashi, Nityananda Nagaram, Hyderabad, New York, Varanasi, Singapore, Singapuram. With this, I welcome all of you with my love and blessings. I'll continue to expand on Mahabharata characters and the various stories. Bhishma, embodiment of righteousness, finds few remains like weapons of Pandavas and sees the dead bodies of the cooks, mistaking them as Pandavas. Pandavas are dead. Is the depression everyone faces during the spiritual practice. Please listen. Listen and understand. When you are doing your spiritual practices, when you live integrity, authenticity, responsibility and enriching, many times you will have a self-confusion whether I am living integrity, authenticity or I really lost everything and just interpreting whatever I want to do as integrity or authenticity. This confusion happens to righteousness. Every individual goes through that confusion. Listen, I'll expand on this one important problem. Every human being goes through this problem during his journey. We call this dark night of the soul. The righteousness itself gets confused. Really, the integrity and authenticity is not saving us? Are they really dead? The doubt goes almost into the depths of your being. Please understand. Look into yourself. I wanted to define about fanaticism. You may think why I am talking about fanaticism here. It will be very useful if you understand the concept of fanaticism with the dark night of the soul. Listen. Dark night of the soul means even your own righteousness losing the confidence over your integrity and authenticity, feeling like you lost it, you lost the game, all your hopes are destroyed, now you are hopeless, you have nothing more to live, you have no future. Listen, now I am defining fanaticism. Fanaticism is if you have transformed yourself and then causing transformation in others, it is teaching, preaching, transforming, causing, but without even you are convinced, you trying to convince others is fanaticism. At some part of you, you are not completely convinced, but you are trying to convince others by force is fanaticism. Whether your righteousness is causing or fanatic, that test is done by the existence at some time, taking away all your hopes. Whether Bhishma himself is transformed and causing, or he is only fanatic. At that time, the intelligence, Vidura, comes and supports, saying, don't worry, intelligence gives the hope. Please understand, the whole Hindu infrastructure itself is such. By the time you evolve as Guru, you would have suffered, struggled enough. Only if you are really, really authentically using integrity, authenticity, responsibility in enriching inside your system, you will even be able to stand up. You will be polished, molded, acid washed so many times in so many ways by the time you sit as Guru. You are qualified. Made to qualify. Here, cosmos is testing Bhishma by giving the wrong evidences that maybe his integrity and authenticity, responsibility of enriching have failed. Maybe his hopes cannot be achieved anymore. Understand, only in during these moments you need Sangha, Sangha Bala. Please understand, Atma Bala alone is not enough for a person to reach the ultimate. You will be able to have more Atma Bala than Bhishma, but even Bhishma is in depression. It is Vidura's support brings Bhishma back to strength. That is why I am telling you, Sangha is one of the very important component necessary. Is life same way? Spirituality also needs Sangha, Sangha Bala. See, if you want to achieve the peak performance in the body, okay, ultimate health, you need that company, that Sangha. If you want to build your body, you need that kind of that gym goers, health freaks as a Sangha. Through the dark night of the soul, many times you have not convinced even some parts of you, but entered the journey. So when you face the life, those parts will be exposed to you. Those tumors will be exposed to you. At that time, you yourself may not be able to handle those tumors independently, just by your own Atma Bala. You need Sangha Bala. I tell you, just yesterday night, all of the Swamis, Kotaris and Mahans, we were sitting in the banks of Ganga and having a session. We were discussing on this subject only. How structure of the Sangha constantly reminds you about your higher purpose and inspires you, raises you to the highest possibility. I have seen sometimes the spiritual seekers till the end of their life, they only had their default flow of life, never conquered, completed their prarabdha and rewrote their future. Please listen. The default flow of your life because of your root pattern is default future. That is there for all of you. It is called default future. The side effect and after effect, the how your life will flow with these root patterns. It is happening. All of you have a default future. If you completed with all the root patterns and you are running your life, that is called prarabdha. The default future because of your root patterns is called agamya. Root patterns are so powerful, you are going to accumulate more and more suffering and karma. That is agamya. They are so incomplete, you are going to accumulate more and more incompletions. The more and more incompletions you are going to accumulate, the more and more incompletions you are going to accumulate, your root patterns, and naturally they are not going to keep quiet, you will constantly accumulate more and more karmas. That is what is agamya, the default future. If you complete with all your root patterns, the default future you will experience is prarabdha. If you complete with all your root patterns and create a new space and rewrite your future, that is called Ishwaratva. You conquer your own life, rewriting your future. Rewriting your future is what is all about inner awakening. This is the right one-liner for inner awakening, rewriting your future. Please listen. Now Bhishma decides to rewrite the future. How he rewrites, we will see in the further satsangs. But I wanted all of you to understand these few things. Don't live your default future. Your default future is not going to help you. It's not going to work. Don't support your root patterns to win over you. Don't help your root patterns to succeed over you. Default future is what we call agamya. And when you complete with your root patterns, the flow of your life is called prarabdha. Only when you rewrite your future, you achieve Ishwaratva. Please understand, Jivan Mukti comes only for the people who achieve Ishwaratva. Because for Jivan Mukti, exhausting your Agamya and Prarabdha alone is not enough. You have to complete even your Sanjita. So complete with your root patterns, complete with your prarabdha. Completing with your root patterns liberates you from the default future. Liberating yourself from the default future is what is liberating yourself from disease, poverty, depression. Please listen. In the inner awakening, I am not teaching you to develop your life. the best techniques to develop your life, develop yourself, change yourself? No. You need to know, till the root is not burnt, even if you try to change your life, develop your life, whether you succeed or fail, you will continue to be struggling. For example, if you change the time you wake up and the yoga you do, even if you are successful in changing it from 7:30 to 4:30, you will be struggling with some other pattern. You will be struggling with the smoking pattern. Even if you are successful in giving up smoking, you will be struggling with this depression pattern. Whether you win or fail, you continue to struggle. That is what is the law of development or change. Even if you change yourself successfully 5 times, you will become more greedy to change yourself in different places. So that will continue to make you struggle. I am not teaching you the science of change or science of developing yourself. My programs are not self-development programs. My programs are not personality development programs. Understand? I am teaching you to rewrite your future. Simply rewrite from till yesterday you were sick, broke, sleeping till 10 o'clock, lazy, fat, ugly, all dash, 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 dash. Just from today you start rewriting the whole future as you want. Understand, inner awakening is all about giving you that breakthrough. It is not about teaching you the science of change. It is teaching you the science of rewriting your future. Burning the roots from which your old personality is established, and giving you the free space to rewrite your new personality. Understand, take the power of rewriting your future in your hands. How? World occurs to you. How? You perceive the matter. Please understand, matter is not reality. How it occurs to you is reality. The good news is your occurrence can be changed. How it occurs to you can be transformed. The bad news is you are in a reality illusion. What you think as reality is not reality, it is illusion. It is the way the matter occurs to you. It is not fact. It is the way the matter occurs to you. Please listen. Your reality is the way matter occurs to you. Transforming, rewriting the world the way the world occurs to you. Rewriting the way the world occurs to you. Transforming the way the world occurs to you is what I call rewriting the future. When you complete with yourself and complete with others, the way the world occurs to you becomes different. When your root patterns loses power over your thinking, please listen, even if you discover your root pattern, you know, whenever your default thinking starts, it is because of my root pattern, I will not encourage this thinking. Even that is a great liberation for you. Once the root pattern completely disappears, that liberation is next. Even remembering, whenever your root patterns guide your thinking, saying, I am not being driven by the petrol car, I am being driven by the bullock cart. I am not being driven by the, I am not being flied by the pilot who knows flying. I am being flied by some fellow who is in the workshop. You will know the difference. Please understand, rewriting your future. Look in. I tell you, continuously grace is flowing. Life means possibility of future. What is life? Possibility of future. But what are you doing? You seal it saying it is nothing new is possible. It is all going to be the repetition of the old. It means what? You denied yourself the possibility of life. Every decision you make for your future from the past pattern, you denied that component of life for yourself once for all. If you think creating wealth is difficult based on some of your past failure, you have denied the possibility of wealth for you once for all. If you think health is not possible for you in the future, due to your past diseases, you denied the greatest possibility of health in your life once for all. If you think enlightenment is impossible for you based on your past failures, you have denied the possibility of enlightenment once for all in your life. Understand, whenever you deny the possibility, you deny your future, you deny your life to you. Anything is possible. Rewriting your future starts with this clarity. Anything is possible. All your impossibility is the projection of your past into the future. Projection of your past into the future. Listen, don't deny the future. Don't deny life. Don't deny life because of past incompletions. If at all you have to put all your struggles in one direction, that is only in one direction, liberating your future from your past. Rewriting your future. That's the only direction you have to put your energy. That's the only direction you have to put your effort. That's the only direction you need to think, you need to work, you need to act. Kalpataru is initiating you into the science of rewriting your future. Kalpataru is helping you to complete with your past incompletions. I tell you, Ganga has opened even for me a new future. She is so powerful, so alive. Many times, my great past disciples have made me lose hope on training new disciples. But Ganga washes away all that and gives me the new hope. I have a possibility. I have a future. I don't need to deny that future. I don't need to deny that possibility. I'm enjoying Ganga, Haridwar so much, really, really, that I have decided to have even March Inner Awakening in Haridwar again. The March Inner Awakening, the date. See, February we have next Inner Awakening, that is in Bidhi. March Inner Awakening, March 6th to March 26th. We are going to have it again in Haridwar. If you missed Inner Awakening in the banks of Ganga, Inner Awakening in the breathing space of completion, When Ganga breathes, she completes you. See the area Ganga breeze reaches, Ganga's wind reaches, carrying the Ganges, carrying the sacred water with itself is a breathing space of Ganga. So even being in the breathing space of Ganga completes you. If you have some most difficult incompletions and you are struggling with it, just come to Ganga, Ganga will wash it away. So if you have missed inner awakening this time, come for March inner awakening, March 6th to March 26th, 2014, next inner awakening in Haridwar. Please listen. Ganga washes away every incompletion, every impossibility. With this, I'll move to the Kalpataru Darshan. Sit straight. Close your eyes. Decide with your integrity, authenticity. Declare with your integrity and authenticity, I complete with all the past incompletions and I will not allow any of my incompletions into the future, into the possibility of the future. Namah Shiva. Again and again and again. Complete with your all past incompletions, all the past failures. Declare to yourself, I will rewrite my future.
Nityanandaya namo om hri, Nityanandaya namo om hri, Nityanandaya namo om hri, Nityanandaya namo om.
Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 08027279999. www.nityananda.org www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.